Are we rolling?
And
Sorry.
Action.
So many people saying action.
Hi Ruchita, we are very excited to have you today here with us and to talk with us. Whenever people think about cricket, they're thinking about, you know, cricketers and all the spiel that we see on TV, etc. But so much happens at the back end. What does a day in the life of Ruchita look like behind the scenes?
I've been working with the IPL for the last 10 seasons and I was with two other teams prior to LSG. I look into the operations. It's all indoor operations where we plan all these lovely fun get-togethers, the jersey signing, merchandise signing, looking into the family day-to-day activity and routine.
You always know that you wanted to do something related to sports, cricket. Was there a passion or was this like, you know, serendipity and you landed and you loved it and you enjoyed it and you stayed? So like, how did this particular role happen for you?
Honestly, I really enjoyed playing cricket as a child. I remember I used to be the only girl with all these boys in my building playing cricket, underarm bowling. I ruled at it. And then, I ended up studying marketing and I worked in Elle magazine. I started off in the media, so Elle magazine, CNBC and so on and so forth. And one fine day I received a call that somebody from an IPL team is looking to hire someone for 3 months. Just to look into sponsor servicing. This was 10 years ago. Went for my first job. My then boss is still my current boss, Raghu Iyer. And went there, bagged the job, and he said that why don't you continue for a longer time? And that was my journey. I mean, I so enjoyed my first season then because, you know, it was the team, the people I was working with, just great people to learn from.
What, according to you, are, you know, the one or two like key skills that you think most come in handy for you as a person to, you know, get all of these things done on time?
One is working under pressure. It's a high controlled environment, a lot of pressure, things, you know, cannot go out, things are within the system. So that is one. Second is being extremely punctual. And third is delivering on time.
You've been mentioning this, you know, this is a high pressure job. Maybe you're managing it really well. It could be that also.
Yeah, it's manageable. It's a lot of fun. You know, it's fun because I love what I do.
So are there any tips that you can share on how you actually make it happen? Like, what does it take to be disciplined in the way that, you know, you're able to drive?
You, by default, have to become really organized in life, which I never was, and just organizing your time and utilizing it well, making notes. There's no shame in asking questions. There is no shame in making notes. Don't understand, ask 10 times and get the job done.
I'd also like to believe that, the team's diet, there's a conscious effort of getting them the right food. The kind of right menu.
I've never seen cricketers follow a diet like the way I have been seeing them this year. KL is very particular about what he eats, and so are all the other players also that I see, you know, their diet. The chef is constantly in touch with them and trying to, you know, make some fun meals for them. But also, you know, we do have a couple of cheat days like our movie nights and all where, you know, there is no diet. Okay, let's go eat what you want. Some of them indulge, some of them don't, but we try.
What do you think is that one spark that keeps you going? Something that you think is that driving force for you?
The spark I think that I have in me is the will and the positivity and the confidence that I have it in me to achieve something that I have to. Whether or not I can or not, I end up doing it. So I think that's the determination that I have in me, that no matter what, don't say no, give it your best and keep pushing for it.
And is there a message that you have for young aspirants who are looking at, you know, careers and just starting off or looking for, you know, their right stream?
Be passionate about whatever you do, whatever you choose, because if there's no passion, you're not going to be able to deliver it at all. You're not going to be into it at all. Whatever career or profession you choose, make sure you're giving it 110%, not even 100%. In order for you to enjoy it.
Great stuff, Ruchita. Thank you. Time for the song. I think you have been telling everyone what the lyrics are, so I don't really think so. I need to tell you or brief you about it.
Sweet super giants, ha ha ha. So good. Listen to your heart, follow your passion, क्योंकि अब जीतेगा स्पार्क ही. And by the way, I forgot to give you a fun fact. I'm the only girl working in the management team.
What is that experience like?
You're loved by all. I think you're really pampered. So I'm always pampered over here. Always ragged over here. All these boys pull my leg. And but it's, you know, it's all in fun. And it's good. It's just good to have, to be the boss woman around.
And if you have a, like, you know, a message that you want to send out to all the girls out there who love cricket, or like, you know, like or not like cricket, I mean, this would be like immense inspiration to them.
Being a woman doesn't make it impossible for you to be a part of any sporting team. Don't get intimidated by, you know, the people around you. Just be who you are, give your 100%, and that's about it. I mean, it doesn't matter. End of the day, it doesn't matter. Women are equally powerful.
We enjoyed talking to you, Rachita. This was awesome.
Every bit and every piece is looked into to make sure that you're feeling the best 11, in the best mood, in the best mindset. Even making sure that a player has a lucky pair of shoes or it's a favorite bat. So it goes down to that very level.